New tonight at 11, it's the end of the line for the Roanoke Valley trash train. The rail spur to the landfill is being paved over, and trucks will soon take over for rail cars. 10 News reporter Shane Dwyer explains why leaders say trains just didn't work anymore.
Construction is underway in rural Montgomery County. Once hailed as revolutionary, all that's left of the Waistline Express train is a stack of railroad ties.
We've been doing due diligence for about 5.5 years now. We started this process back in 2016.
Dan Miles is the CEO of the Roanoke Valley Resource Authority. For nearly 30 years, the trash train and its gondola cars split from the Norfolk Southern Main Line in Ironto, traveling 5 miles here to the tipper at the landfill. But due to rising freight costs and equipment issues, the tipper has gone dark.
Our board ended up deciding to go ahead and make the transition to move forward with the trucking.
Trash will now be trucked here to the landfill from near downtown Roanoke via Interstate 81. Where the rail was cut, a new road will begin just north of the truck stop.
It's just a 5-mile driveway to the facility. It's a full 2-lane road, but it's not open to the general public. It is for operational use only.
Jeremy Garrett is the operations manager and watched the rails get ripped up. Crews are preparing to pave over the remaining ballast, and the trucks should be moving by mid-July.
Directly into the backside of our facility, so there will be no need for us to go on any public roads once we get off of Interstate 81 under the new operation.
For now, the Valley's trash is being trucked to the Dublin landfill, and only wastewater trucks are on the local roads. It's the latest split between the railroad and the region that it birthed, and although local politicians tried to save it 3 years ago, Miles says short-haul rail just doesn't work.
Show me somebody else that's doing it. Nobody else in our area is doing it, and there's a reason for it.
In Roanoke County, Shane Dwyer, 10 News, working for you.
It's unclear what will happen to the rail car tipper moving forward. It was one of the largest in the world when it entered service.